Greetings everyone, my name is Bife here. So the recent wave of gaming news will doubtless have you informed about the existence of the upcoming Borderlands 3, a fact that is so well known that the 3 in the title probably stands for the number of people that haven't been told yet. As a looter shooter, with a vast world and, as they advertise, a billion guns, it's no doubt got the attention of a lot of you guys out there, and it's at this point that quite a lot of you started to ask that question that I just knew I'd have to answer at some point. Namely, hey, Bife, are you going to make lore videos on Borderlands? So, time for this very overdue video, seeing as a collective consciousness we all sort of knew that Borderlands 2 was too successful not to get a sequel. I should really have known ever since I started playing Destiny that this was going to be a topic I would need to cover one day, but hey, here we are. So, this question should really be a cut and dry one for me. I should be looking at this and seeing a really big opportunity. And that's part of the reason why I've not been really responding as much as pondering the emails that the UK PR rep from 2K Games has sent me. Hi, by the way. Regardless, this is something that I needed to explain to everyone involved. That of course means you, the viewer at home, watching the video. You see, as a content creator, this game represents a chance to get into a community that hasn't really been touched for a very long time, and it's a game where you guys playing it are basically my free leg in the door as far as a potential viewer base is concerned, because a lot of you guys have asked me to do this. A lot of you guys on Twitter have said, hey, Bife, jump in, please, this is another game that we're going to be playing. This is great, frankly, because it's one of the reasons why I was scared to get into lore of things like the Soulsborne games. That and also Vati Vidya, being the excellent creator that he is, has all of that covered, and for the most part, I am willing to accept that whilst I could ascend to the rank of a Git Good God, I probably would lose all or any semblance of a sleep schedule along my way. So, yeah, that's a tough thing to balance. Something else that'll lend a lot of confidence to the idea of me working on this series and just bringing Borderlands content into the channel generally is the fact that, relatively speaking, it's an untapped part of the community lore. A lot of people will focus on loot and let's plays, but not as many focus on lore. You see hundreds of videos on Vati Vidya and all of the content from my fellow Destiny creators like Myelin Games, but you don't see many in Borderlands. You see a ton of people covering the lore for other games, but I don't know if it's just the big focus of Borderlands. Now, that's not to say that those videos don't exist or that the creators who are making them are lackluster, quite the opposite. I just think it's an area of the game that it doesn't really focus on itself as much as it focuses on something like, say, the core story, which might be something to cover, or guns and loot, which is definitely something a little bit further outside of my typical content now. So, with all that said, I should really outline that this video is a question to all of you. Namely, should I cover Borderlands 3 and Borderlands lore more generally? Whilst, as I just stated, the answer might have seemed obvious, I'm really not so sure, and the reasons why are as follows. And before anything else is said, I do hope you can understand that my skepticism is not born of any hatred of the game, it's more born of indecision, and, well, yeah, I just don't know. First of all, I've almost never played a Borderlands game. My friends and I played it at one point for a T-Slape episode that never aired because I just didn't quite find it fitting in with all the gags of the game and our gags meshing together really badly, and it really wasn't quite right, so ultimately that's part of the reason why we kind of dropped it. So yeah, to say that I'm inexperienced in the area of Borderlands as far as the story and the lore goes is therefore a bit of an understatement. I would need to learn everything. I have been playing Destiny for the sum total of, oh god, it's getting on 5 or 6 years now, and I've been covering it since way back when in 2013. So, yeah, a very long time, shall we say. Having said all of that, it's not impossible that I could adapt, and it's not impossible that I could learn things. Problem number two, however, is that Borderlands is very different from Warframe, Anthem, or Destiny. Whilst in those other games it seems pretty clear that there's a serious tone to the world, in Borderlands things are just not that way. I mean, take Mr. Talk, who sold his company for 10 bucks and a high five, if I'm remembering the amounts in the lore correctly. Or Tiny Tina, who has an entire DLC that is literally just playing a D&D game, although admittedly the sub-elements to it and the entire point of her emotional journey and losing who is essentially a father figure to her definitely plays a role in that, not to give any spoilers for those of you who haven't played Borderlands 2. On top of that, you could even look at weapons such as the Teodor guns, which turn into grenades that you can throw when you reload them functionally. You see, all of this is fantastic and there is a world built here that is really rich, but I don't know if I have the right tone to cover that story. As far as a storyteller goes, I mean, look at me. I'm a dude who stinks of posh Englishman, but I don't know how well that translates into talking about the lore of a game and a world where the sword explosion shotgun exists. And for those of you who don't know, that is from Tiny Tina's Assault on Dragon Keep, and it is a shotgun that shoots swords that explode into other swords that also explode, because it's Borderlands. It is not like Destiny, where you have things such as Razelighter, which is a sword created from the remains of a Hive God's sword, taken slowly from darkness to light, and eventually transformed into the Blade of Day it is. This isn't a place where the Praxic Order exists, and the Drifter comes along with his strange motives. There is intrigue in the world of Borderlands, but it's not the same. It does not have the same tone. It's a much more light-hearted, comedic feel. And I am, frankly, a somber guy sometimes. You know, when I sit down and talk about the world of Saint 14, I don't know if that necessarily means it's a voice that can translate into talking about the world of Mr. Talk. So, that's reason number two. And reason number three, one of the more practical reasons. This game comes out in September. And if anyone knows what else comes out in September, and also had an interest in the aforementioned sleep schedule of mine, then you'll know that that could be a sign of trouble. You see, having two major releases like this to focus on is just, well, it's just too much. I'd need to put something like 20 hours into the games a day, and honestly, that's neither healthy nor something I feel like doing. To give you a little bit of earlier context, when Rise of Iron released, it was the same year as Dishonored 2, and I was wrapping up a sponsored project on Dishonored 2 at the time being. I'd been working with Arkane to help bring the story to life with a few artists and animators, and it was a great project, but by that same token, it tired me out because I was working on another game, and it cut into my time where I should have been covering Rise of Iron. And that kind of screwed with my content. It was the first time that I started to really feel an exceptionally large amount of burnout in comparison to everything else. Thankfully, I had friends who were willing to pick me out of the gutter there. I just didn't learn my lessons, which is why it happened again. I like to think that I'm wiser now, but covering two games that are really popular at that moment for all sakes and purposes is practical. Yeah, that could put me in an unhealthy situation. The long story short of all this is that covering something in an extensive fashion like that, as well as covering a second game, such as Destiny, would just not be healthy. And it would be really tricky to balance if I was going to try and make it healthy. Hell, some of you even want me to go back and cover Monster Hunter World again ahead of the Iceborne expansion, which will be awesome, by the way, but that will still be something that I don't have time to play at all. All of these games land in September, and if I'm going to cover them, I'm going to need to play them, and that means rapidly evaporating whatever time I have left, which in the last 8 months I've realized has burned me out and put me in a really, really bad place. That month off that I took because I was starting to get burnt and depressed to the point where I wasn't making content that was worthy of the channel, yeah. That happened because of moments like back where I was covering both Rise of Iron and Dishonored. That happened because there was too much going on all at once. That is how burnout happens. That is how you lose all of the content that I could potentially be making. That is how I deliver subpar content, and that suits nobody. All of these games landing in September presents that practical reality, and again, it has put me in a really, really bad place. Now, all of those above points might make it sound like I'm telling you guys that I don't want to cover Borderlands at all, but that's not the case. There are some compelling reasons as to why I mightn't want to cover it, but ultimately there are also really compelling reasons why I might want to cover it. So, I ultimately still need to put the question to you, because you guys are the deciding factor in so much of what I make. Do you want me to cover Borderlands 3 or try? I could simply try to put out content and see how it does, but I'd want to know a little more from you guys personally. Do you think it's worth it? Maybe I'll be able to tell if there's an audience from the views on this video or if a large number of comments are on this video telling me to do it. Regardless, I really need this input right now because it's time to make a decision. There are things around the corner that I should be looking into if I really want to get into covering this game, and the fact that the poor 2K rep in my emails doesn't know what the hell I'm doing is not helpful to either of us. I also have to ask all of you to appraise me of the situation. What's the focus of Borderlands like, aside from the initial comedic humor? Is there an extensive amount of lore, as akin to something like, say, World of Warcraft, Destiny, Warframe? Are there plots within plots? Does it have the kind of storytelling that leads you down an Oryx-sized rabbit hole? Or is it a little thinner than that, but maybe a little wider? What's the world like outside of the humor? Is there anything interesting going on with the factions? Is there any interesting faction outside of the Psychos and Hyperion that I just don't know about? Does the universe make you ask questions? Tell me. Give me data. I ultimately have to admit that I am ignorant on the subject, and I don't take it as an insult if you need to promptly educate me on what's what in the game, or if you're dying to tell me about some particular aspect of it all that makes you think I need to cover it. Part of me, right now, sees this as a clear opportunity that I might regret not taking, and a part of me also sees it as potential FOMO that this mentality of mine might just be breeding. I'm partly thinking about it because it's Borderlands, but perhaps I should be thinking about it as far as whether or not it's compatible to myself and my channel. And I'll not lie, it has me so torn that this question is one that I was turning over in my mind since I saw the trailer at PAX. It's been eating me over the last few days, and that is far from something I'm comfortable with. I also want to convey that I'm asking you guys because this is a really strange time for the channel. It's not exactly in a bad place. Destiny videos still tend to get over 100,000 views every single time they're released, and that is of course over the period of a week, but nonetheless some get more. I'm really happy with the community that we've built across both the channel and the attached Discord server, which you can find in the description by the way, I know a few people ask here and there, and it's stable. Also, speaking of stable, my working situation, it is workable at current. It is fine. The current outlook for content looks solid no matter what I do, and I don't see myself being unable to immediately pay rent or feel uncomfortable, but it's no longer a calculation about the now, it is a calculation about the future. And for all I know, the me of the future is going to have trouble with bills because that's how uncertain YouTube ends up being. Make no mistake, I'm not struggling to put food on my table, but this is not about the now. It is about what might come in the future. With the landscape I'm living in at current as well, you will note that Britain is a tad unstable, and being somebody in a self-employed career that is frankly making videos on the internet, it is very, very odd trying to make videos and then think that I have a 100% stable job. YouTube is already unstable. So, yeah, it's tough. I feel conflicted with Borderlands because I need knowledge, and I need to understand whether you guys would actually want to watch something like that. It is an important decision, it is something that will affect the channel, it is something that affects me personally. But make no mistake, I will gladly put in the time and investment to make all of this happen, I will research the lore behind everything, but before I do that, I need to feel confident in my decision. Because if I'm going to continue to cover Destiny and Warframe, and if I'm going to go ahead and keep my focus narrow to those few games, if I'm going to think about covering something else again, such as Anthem, I need to be confident in that decision. That is the reason why I've stopped covering games. When Monster Hunter World stopped adding content in a reasonable fashion, that was the point at which I saw a declining player base, and even though the game is phenomenal and the story there is fantastic, I didn't see it as worth doing more, because ultimately, the void has been filled. When it came to Anthem, I did not like the conversation around the game, and whilst it was ultimately something that did drive me to a studio that I loved, it was also something that drove me to a game that I started to despise. I have still not maxed leveled myself in Anthem, and that is just a show of how little I wanted to play the game. I could not bear going through it, and I did not feel confident in making the decision to make content on that game. Borderlands 3 is not Anthem, Borderlands 3 is not Monster Hunter World, but Borderlands 3 is a question mark of a different kind. So yeah, help me square this circle, help me feel confident about whatever decision I make, because ultimately, it is all about you guys. If enough of you want this, I'll do it. I think this is important enough where it might be worth linking a straw poll in the description. I don't know, I'll go ahead and throw it in there, and maybe you guys can give me a little bit of insight. If there is something that you want me to know about this, please let me know. But I want everyone to also be assured of something else. After all the concern that you guys raised, quite rightly, when I took my break, I've been focusing a lot more on making sure that my time is spent not burning out and ensuring that I get proper time off. I'm in a lot more situations where I don't need to think about videos for the space of a whole week. I am in a very, very good place with regards to getting contact with the outside world. I am healthier. I am getting better sleep. But I don't want to damage that. So I'm going to need to see about finding a way to make things fit. If you want Borderlands content, that simply informs me of what I need to do with the channel. And that's fine. However, if you don't, things remain unchanged. If you want Destiny content to be eclipsed by Borderlands content, that also means things need to change. But this is all a series of commentary and decisions that I need help making. I do not believe I'm going to do something as drastic as covering only Borderlands. That is something that I think is an uncomfortable step. I think the most likely thing is to cover both, and I'm sure that's what most of you will choose, but just let me know. Because right now, I am in that very odd place, and I need to understand what the right choice is, and the only way to know that is through you guys. Not to put it blankly and coldly, because I know I've already spoken about Rent, but you guys are not just the thing that motivates me, you are also, in this cold and cynical world, my paycheck. And that is something that is awful to have to analyze and acknowledge, but that is the reality of things. So I am here to serve whatever you want. I am here to do something. If somebody can give me a point at which they show that the passion of content that I can produce is worthy of Borderlands, then please, 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 let me know. Because I need a little direction here. I need to know. If you are incredibly passionate and want to let me know that Borderlands is worth covering, please let me know. Because I need help making this decision. It is urgent that I make this decision within the next few days and think about this imminently. So, yeah, I guess all I'm trying to say is I need you guys. You are the people that have always given me direction. When you guys were supportive of me taking a break, that meant that I could take it without guilt. It meant that I could feel properly rested, and that made me better. When you guys were supportive of me moving back in Destiny 2's launch from a news and generalist channel that sometimes covered lore into the main channel that covered lore for Destiny, that was a big decision, but it was one made with the confidence that you guys were by my side. So, help me make another decision here. Do I think about covering Borderlands even if it's just for a short spurt? Tell me, what do you think? In the meantime though, the comments section down below is open. Please tell me what you think, and if you want to know more, well, stick around. I'll probably talk about it in the next few videos, and if you want updates, my Twitter is there. This wasn't really content, and this did get in the way of videos I planned on making this week, but I felt like I needed to ask this question. The Shadows of Your Stuff is going to be the first thing we make next week. It'll be dropping maybe Wednesday next week. Following up after this video, we're also going to have the first Invitation of the Nine, and then we're going to be investigating a very special topic on a fan-favorite Guardian that some people might not have seen, and some people have definitely asked about where she is. Anyway, all of that said, thank you so much for watching. Your viewership, as always, is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been My Name is Bife. Purodasya Adastra. I'll see you, Starside.